Hi, hello, how are you doing? Welcome back. I couldn't find a cardigan, but I got the next best thing, which is a flannel. I think we're staying on brand. I think it's, you know, we're still here. We're still in the moment. The moment being listening to Folklore last week, and since then,
not being able to stop listening to Folklore this week.
You read the title. You know what we're about to dive into today. But before we do, I have to... In OG YouTuber style, I have to apologize. I have to make an apology video for specifically two individuals. Actually, maybe three individuals. Let's just go sit down on the floor and apologize.
Okay. Don't mind the outfit change. The flannel wasn't really giving me sorrow. I'm just kidding. Firstly, I would like to apologize to none other than the star of 2016's breakout summer hit, The Shallows, Blake Lively. I am so sorry, Blake. I didn't realize how stressful it is to name a child. And honestly, if the name Inez fits whatever hole you have in your heart, who am I to judge that? It's a beautiful name. You get to use the last letter in the alphabet. Not a lot of names can do that. Zachariah, no one likes a Zachariah, though. Let's be real, come on. Zach, ugh, that's even worse. Jesus, don't get me started on Zachs. Actually, that's not true. I know a lot of really, really nice Zachs. But anyways, the second person I would like to formally apologize to is Blake Lively's husband. I don't know why I'm blanking on a name right now. Ryan Seacrest? No. Wait, what? Is he in the script? What did it say in the script? Okay, anyways. Sorry. Actually, I don't really even care about him. Okay, whatever. Moving on. Most importantly. Sorry, hold on. I'm running low on wetness. Ah, come on. Whew. Inez, I'm so sorry for making fun of your sweet, adorable name that was bestowed upon you by no choice of your own. Might I add, it's a beautiful name. And I'm sure you're gonna have a lot of boys be screaming it to the sky as you break their hearts, you know? So I am truly sorry. Let's get back to the video though. Hugh Jackman? Does she marry Hugh Jackman? I don't know. Okay, anyway, okay, let's go back.
Okay, I think I covered all my bases with that one. And speaking of covering bases, I really wanted to make sure that I caught every little detail in Evermore. So I thought, why have me ramble on and on about this album that I don't know anything about? Why don't I bring in a professional? Why don't I bring in a real Swifter, you know? A real Swiffer. I have a sneaky suspicion some of y'all might know her. She's Australian. She has a reaction channel as well as her own YouTube channel. May I please present Bonny Rebecca?
Woo!
Oh my gosh, and then there's the tailor. Oh, perfect. Oh my God. And the candle. Oh, mwah, mwah. So like going into Evermore, are there a few like little things in songs kind of like Betty that I should like know? Like don't like obviously no spoilers, but like kind of things I should know?
Okay. I think so. I mean, like are we filming already?
Yeah, I'm recording this whole Zoom. I'm recording this whole Zoom. Yeah.
No, that's fine.
I got you picking your nose. I got you rubbing your eye, everything. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I'm so excited if you listen to Evermore because there is lots of things like that as well. And it is like such a similar energy, but like different at the same time. Like, oh, I'm just excited to hear like how you feel about it in comparison. But there's a few things that are similar to Folklore in the sense that like songs are connected, or like what fans think songs are connected. And I think I kind of mentioned to you this already. People say that 'Tis the Damn Season and Dorothea are like the same situation from two perspectives. In Dorothea, one person is singing about Dorothea. And in 'Tis the Damn Season, that person, Dorothea, is singing about the other person.
Okay.
Champagne Problems is like the most illegal song you're ever gonna hear. And it's a similar energy to Cardigan in the sense that it just does not give you a second to breathe.
Cool. So I'm just gonna ball. What track is that one? Number one?
No, it's number two. It's track two.
Cool. Oh, great.
Yeah, like cool. Awesome. And that one is really interesting because the whole kind of concept for that song is that a couple, they show up on the same night, one with the plans to propose and the other with the plan to end it. Taylor and Joe wrote that together. Yeah, so like it's just a lot.
Dude, if I wrote a song like that with somebody that I love, I'd just have to be like, hey, are we okay though? Like, are we good? It's like, yeah, we're good. We're like, are we good though?
Ongoing joke, like amongst the fandom that like Taylor and Joe just like love to just like pretend like if something happened and then, like, cool. Happiness is so offensive. Oh my God.
It's offensive. Okay. I feel like we're getting into spoiler territory now.
Marjorie is about her grandmother who was an opera singer. And that's important information to keep in mind because yeah, there's some sounds that happen. Do you have any questions that you feel like clarifying or anything that you want to know about anything before you go into this so you can get most out of it?
Yeah. So one box of tissues or two? You
think? Honestly, like, yeah.
Yeah. Just yes.
Yeah. Just yes. I'm like, I try not to spoil, but like, I want to give you little things because I really think they'll help you like fully
don't worry when it's all edited and you're watching it, you can scream those things at me at the computer screen as I will.
For sure.
Let's do the YouTube goodbye and then we'll do an actual
goodbye. Okay. yeah
Okay, cool. Thanks so much for hanging out with me today on Zoom, prepping me for this journey right now, Bonny. I really appreciate it.
You're so welcome. I'm happy to be here and to be chatting and to like be prepping you up ready for your next journey into Taylor Swift. You've only got another 7 albums to go. So, and we do expect them.
Yep. Comment section's been reminding me of that. Well, thank you. I'm going to get into it. And I'm sure everybody in the comment section already knows who you are, but go ahead and tell the people where you're at, like plug yourself.
Oh, well, my name's Bonny and I have a YouTube channel called Chats and Reacts where we kind of do a similar thing, but usually with my best friend Emily as well, but she can't be with us today. So she says hello to everyone.
Hello, Emily.
Yeah. So yeah, that's kind of the deal.
Awesome. Cool.
Yeah.
Go subscribe to her, guys. You know the deal, you know, push the button, just do it. All righty then. Thank you, Bonny. Very, very happy to have you on the channel. Definitely go check her channel out. I'll leave a link in the description as well. Oh God.
Darling.
I'm trying to like hype myself up right now because I know that these lyrics are just gonna be
so sad, dude.
I mean, I'm trying to stay hydrated right now, but I mean, like, honestly, there's barely anything left. Alrighty, we are listening to the Evermore Deluxe version with 17 songs. And the first one is Willow, which is the most popular song on her Spotify at this moment. So it must be good, right? Let's check it out. Here we go, Evermore.
Diving in deep, woo!
Oh, the guitar already.
I'm like the water when your ship rolled in that night.
Oh, okay.
On the surface, but you cut through like a knife.
Alright, spit.
The more that you say, the less I know. Whatever you stray, I follow.
Oh.
I'm begging for you to take my hand. Wreck my plans, that's my man.
Oh, no. Bent right to you. That's my man. Oh, I love all the noodling. I love noodling guitars, dude. Oh my God.
You say the less I know, wherever you stray, I follow.
Oh,
you to take my
I already know the chorus. I already know it. I already know it. Dude. Oh, give me that bridge.
Life was a willow and it bent right to you. I come back stronger than a 90s trend.
Whoa.
The more that you say, you say, the less I know. Wherever you stray, I follow. I'm begging for you to take my hand, pick my plans, that's my man. The more that you say,
oh yo, that's my man.
Whatever you say, hey, that's my man. I'm begging for you to take my hand, pick my plans, that's my man.
What the... Dude, straight out the gate with a bopper, dude. That makes sense. That makes sense. Very valid. Very valid. Most popular song on Spotify? Yeah. No, I'd,
I shake my ass to that.
Brother, the way she takes that last chorus and how she really changes up the little different melodies, because we have been hearing that same thing over and over again. It's not getting old, but like... It is the same thing over and over again. Wreck my plans, that's my man. I'm not gonna take me. The way she subverts that at the end of this last chorus and how she gets into that lower
octave.
That's a real sweet spot to end a song, and I really dig that. Produced by, I'm gonna say Aaron. I'm gonna guess Aaron. Who is it? That's Aaron Dresner. That's right, baby. That's right. And guess what? They got every single one of the instruments credited. Got the French horn, keyboard, synthesizer, flute, glockenspiel. Jason Truting on glockenspiel. Jason, my guy, I have to inform you, you just might have the best job in the world. Right under me. Moving on, the next song is Champagne Problems. And... I'm scared? Oh, it's the classic progression. Oh no. Oh no.
You booked the night train for a reason, so you could sit there in this hurt. Because I dropped your hand while dancing, left you out there standing, crestfallen on the landing. Champagne problems. Your mom's ring in your pocket, my picture in your wallet. Your heart was glass, I dropped it. Champagne problems.
Oh, where's my dictionary? Where's my thesaurus? Jeez, crestfallen?
You told your sister splashed out on the bottle. Now no one's celebrating. Dom Perignon, you brought it. No crowd of friends applauded. Your hometown skeptics called it champagne problems. Had a speech, you're speechless. Love slipped beyond your reaches, and I couldn't give a reason. Champagne problems.
Ooh, okay, yep. Yep. Oh, thank God I'm wearing glasses. Like when I say it just clicked, it like just clicked.
One for the money, two for the show. I never was ready, so I watch you go. Sometimes you just don't know the answer till someone's on their knees and asks you. She would have made such a lovely bride. What a shame she's fucked in the head, they said. But you'll find the real thing instead. She'll patch up your tapestry that I shred.
Oh my God.
Won't remember all my shame.
Oh my God. Oh, what? Oh, dude. I just wanna say to anybody who likes to comment.
Oh, I think he's just putting it on, man. I think he's just exaggerating. I can't tell if he's exaggerating or not.
I can't see out of my eyes right now.
Because I'm crying so much. Oh, I didn't know it was gonna hit on that, bro. What? I'm gonna be honest with you. I don't have the emotional strength to break these lyrics down for you right now.
my glasses are literally fogged up right now. I'm crying so much.
Who gave you the right? Let me see your license to songwrite, dude. I need to check something. I don't think your coverage covers this. In an essay about Evermore, Swift states the song depicts longtime college sweethearts who had a very different plans for the same night. One to end it and one who brought a ring. Oh. The song implies that a protagonist has a history of mental illness, which a town subsequently stigmatizes in their relation. Gossip surrounding the failed mental health is a topic. Oh, shit. Oh, I can't do it. I can't do it. Oh, I can't do it. Just go read it for yourself. Just go read it for yourself. Woo! Sorry, I'm clipping. Oh, my God. I've got to take him off again.
Oh, Taylor.
This sucks because I listen to albums when I drive, and when I drive long distances, I always see those Swift trucks. I know you know what I'm talking about. You see the Swift transportation trucks, and I always think,
oh, man, I guess Taylor Swift's music career didn't work out. She's on a truck.
I'm just so stupid. Now when I see those trucks, I'm gonna start bawling, and I'm gonna get in a car accident, go off the road, smash into a ditch because I was reminded of this song. The next song is called Gold Rush. Oh, please, please spare me. Jack Antonoff, please come rescue me.
Be nice to me. Be nice to me. Jack, be nice to me.
Nice ambience. Dude, I gotta say it. I'm sorry. He's so good at transitions. Ah, he's just good at it. Okay.
I don't like that anyone would die to feel your touch. Everybody wonders what it would be like to love you. Walk past, quick brush. I don't like slow motion, double vision in rose blush. Everybody wants you, but I don't like a gold rush. What must it be like
to oh, keys! Cheek change!
On into place like dominoes. A gold rush, gold rush. I don't like anticipating.
Oh, and he's all.
I don't like that anyone would die to feel your touch. I don't like slow motion, double vision in rose blush. I don't like them, I don't like a gold rush. What must it be like?
Yes, yes, yes.
Turns your life into folklore.
Folklore.
I can't dare to dream about you. Found, we'll never see love as pure as it will never be.
Jackie boy, thank you. Thank you for giving me just that kick drum. Just the kick drum itself. Just the... Thank you. I needed it. Verse 1. What it must be like to grow up that beautiful. With your hair falling in place like dominoes, I see me paddling across your wooden floors with my Eagles t-shirt hanging from the door. Okay, so this is a song depicting the jealousy she has because she's attracted to someone who everybody admires. God, that is such an interesting topic to be able to write about. It just frames the relationship so much differently. And I just love Jack's production. I just think he's just so incredible, man. What is it like to be just born beautiful? I wonder that. I truly believe that hot people just live in a different world. The next song is called "Tis the Damn Season." And I remember Bonny telling me about this one, but I don't exactly remember what she said because when we zoomed, it was like, really early in the morning for me, and now it's later, but here we go. Tis the damn season.
Ooh.
Ooh, I love that guitar. Oh, that is a weird, really low one. Hanging with while I was gone, I would have asked you. It's an ache in you, put there by the ache in me. That snare and that right ear only. Interesting. Call me babe for the weekend. Tis the damn season right this time. I'm staying at my parents' house. And the road not taking looks real good now. And it always leads to you and my hometown. I parked my car. Okay. Between the method. I like hometowns too, man. I can't not see it, but hometown just always reminds me of punk pop, and that's just always what I'm gonna think of when I think of the word hometown. So I see you singing about hometowns, Taylor Swift. But if it's okay with you, it's okay with me. Sleeping half the day just for ooh, that real. Really low end right there. I'll go back to LA and the so-called friends who write books about me if I ever make it and wonder about the only soul now. Time flies, this thing is the mind on your truck ties. Now I'm missing your smile. Hear me out. We could end in my hometown. Very catchy song. I didn't really quite catch the lyrics as much as I wish I did, but it says down here, in the liner notes of the album, Swift wrote that one of the song's storylines on Evermore was about what happens when Dorothea comes back from Hollywood for the holidays and rediscovers her old flame. This likely refers to Tis the Damn Season, giving the lyrical mentions of both Los Angeles and the winter holidays. Notably, Evermore was released 2 weeks prior to Christmas 2020, which makes the timing very timely, but it doesn't right now because I'm
6 months late.
Actually, more like 8 months late to this album. Sorry. I'm a sleeper, dude. I was hibernating. I was just hibernating, you know, in my hometown. But all right, moving on to the next one, which is called Tolerate It. And here we go. Ooh.
Sit and watch you reading with your head low, breathing with your eyes closed. I sit and watch you and notice everything you do or don't do.
I do.
You smile, wait by the door like I'm just a kid. I know my life should be celebrated. You tolerate it. I greet you with a wave by the door like I'm just a kid. Use my best colors for your portrait.
See those little clickety clackities in the back.
But you tolerate it.
Oh my god.
While you were out building other worlds, where was I? Break free and leave us in ruins. Took this dagger and me.
Oh my god. Talk about something that's just like literally one of your biggest fears in a relationship is that your partner just ends up not loving you as much as you do. The song is about a continuous struggle of wanting love from someone who isn't even paying attention to anything that you do for them. All right, well, moving on to Nobody, No Crime. Technically, yes. Well, no, not really. Family. You gotta make sure that all the family, there's no family involved, or whoever's gonna check on them. No, there's still crime. Still crime. I'd say nobody, potential, still crime would be a more adequate title for this. But it's featuring Hume, and it's produced by Taylor and Aaron.
Aaron and Tay Tay.
He did it.
my god. Oh, this is dirty. Oh, the harmonica. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He's a friend of mine. Up every Tuesday night for dinner and a glass of wine. Esty's been losing sleep. Her husband's acting different and it smells like infidelity.
Ooh, you dirty bitch. On his
mouth. That ain't my jewelry on our joint account. No, there ain't no doubt. I think he did.
I think.
But I just can't prove it.
I think you can prove it.
I think he did it, but I just can't prove it. Nobody, no crime, but I ain't letting up until the day I die.
Ooh. Oh, this is that nice. Okay, come on, Taylor. Actually, I'm gonna pause you right there. Just gotta say, I love this twangy, funky country vibe right here. It makes me feel good, brother. It makes me feel good.
Where he reports his missing wife. And I noticed when I passed his house, his truck has got some brand new tires. And his mistress moved in. Sleeps in Esty's bed and everything.
Oh.
There ain't no doubt. Somebody's gotta catch him out. Cause I think he did it, but I just can't prove it. I think he did it, but I just can't prove it. I think he did it, but I just can't prove it. No, nobody, no crime, but I ain't letting up until the day I die.
Yeah, wow.
Daddy made me get a boating license when I was 15.
Okay, flex, flex.
I've cleaned enough houses to know how to cover up a scene.
Ooh.
Good thing Esty's sister's gonna swear she was with me.
She was with me, dude.
Good thing his mistress took out a big life insurance policy.
Oh.
They think she did it, but they just can't.
Oh my god.
They think she did it, but
oh,
they just
she did. Oh, bitch.
She thinks I did it, but she
this is her now.
Can't prove it. No, nobody, no crime. I wasn't letting up until the day. No, nobody, no crime. I wasn't letting up until the day.
Ow.
I wasn't letting up until the day.
Oh, I like that twangy. I like that twangy feel. I love that. Love how the little flip at the end where she's like, yeah, she definitely did it. And now she's the one that can't, like, you know, nobody can prove she actually did it. He was doing it. She knew it. She took him out. She went, you know, she gone girled it. All right, moving on to the seventh track called Happiness. Is this going to bring me happiness? I don't know, dude. Kind of a mixed bag. I mean, that one was a jam, but I don't know. Is this one going to make me want to, like, die? More like sadness, maybe? Oh, nice big pad. Love me a big pad. Love a big pad, dude. Give me that nice synth pad.
Honey, when I'm above the trees, all the years I've given is just shit we're dividing up.
Oh.
Showed you all of my hiding spots.
That was right. This is sad.
I was dancing when the music stopped. I haven't met the new me yet. There'll be happiness after you. But there was happiness because of you. Both of these things can be true. There is happiness past the blood and bruise. Past the curse.
Okay, maybe it's not sad. Maybe it's happy.
The terror in the nightfall. When did your winning smile begin to look like a smurf?
Fuck. Fuck, dude.
I hope she'll be a beautiful fool who takes my spot next to you. No, I didn't mean that. Sorry, I can't see.
facts through all of my fury. In our history, across a great divide, there is a glorious sunrise, dappled with the flickers of light from the dress I wore at midnight. Leave it all behind. Make it go away.
Whoa.
Whoa. It's the price I paid for 7 years in heaven.
Damn, 7 years though? That's a
body and a mind every goddamn night. Now I get fake niceties. No one teaches you what to do. A good man hurts you, and you know you hurt him too.
Dude, classic, man. Dude, just a classic. It's like the whole don't be sad, it's over, be happy that it happened vibe. You feel me? She always just writes that so beautifully, man. Well, the next song is Dorothea. Another just honestly really old ass name, dude. It's just a really old ass. Can we get some maybe like a Sharon in there, maybe? Maybe like a nice Oliver? A little more recent, you know? I don't want like a Shailene or anything like that, you know? No offense. No offense, Shailene. Okay, moving on. Dorothea. Come on.
Hey, Dorothea, do you ever stop and think about me?
Oh!
When we were younger, down in the park, honey, making a lark of the misery.
A lark. Yeah, making a lark.
Your friends since the stars in your eyes shined brighter and Tupelo. And if you're ever tired of being known for who you know, you always know me, Dorothea.
Aww. That's so cute.
Ooh, selling dreams, selling makeup and magazines.
Oh yeah, no, this is a vibe now.
And damn Dorothea, they all wanna be ya, but are you still the same soul I met under the bleachers? Well, ooh, but it's never too late to come back to my side. The stars in your eyes shine brighter in Tupelo. And Dorothea.
Oh, I love that. Wow, that is so sweet, man. Oh, God. It took me a second for it to hit, but now I'm just like, I'm reading into it and like, oh, dude. I see the connection with 'Tis the Damn Season. I see it, dude. It's like, you're always gonna have those hometown people, bro.
Oh.
I married my hometown person, just to flex on you guys. Also, can you hear the rain outside? Thank you. Thank you, Earth, for making up for my lack of tears on this, but geez, I'm feeling it, man. Well, moving on, number 9, called Coney Island, and it's featuring The National. Okay, cool. Oh, I like the progression so far.
Break my soul in two, looking for you, but you're right here.
I'm right here.
I can't relate to you any more than who am I related to.
Oh God, this is gonna hurt. Oh.
And I'm sitting on a bench in Coney Island, wondering where did my baby go? The fast times, the bright lights, the merry-go.
Oh, the bells in the back.
Sorry for not making you my centerfold. Lost again with no surprises. Disappointments, close your eyes. And it gets colder and colder. And the sun goes down.
Oh, man.
It was a lifetime of achievement.
Oh, my God.
Will you forgive my soul when you're too wise to trust me and too old to care?
Wow. Oh my God.
We were like the mall before the internet. Were you waiting at a old spot in the tree line by the gold clock? Did I leave you hanging every single day?
Were you standing in the hallway with a big cake? Happy birthday. Did I paint your bluest skies the darkest gray? The universe way. And when I got into the accident, the sight that flashed before me was your face.
Sorry for not making you mine, making you mine, making you my centerfold.
Dude. Jeez, man. His voice, just gotta say, unreal, dude. Whoa. What a tone, dude. I definitely see the symmetry and the similarities between Coney Island being like a rundown place, but used to be there for great times, and then...
And then not being.
And next one is called Ivy. Give me something happy. Please give me something happy. Please. I don't...
How's one to know I'd meet you where the spirit meets the
bones. Ooh, I like that.
And a faithful God to
finger style.
In from the snow, your touch brought forth an incandescent glow. Tarnished but so grand. And the old widow goes to the stone every day. But I don't let
Wait,
you
what?
Sit here.
Dude, incandescent glow, stone. Is she talking about the mind stone? Is she though? Ooh.
Taking mine, but it's been promised to another road. I can't stop you putting roots in my dreamland. My house of stone, your ivy grows, and now I'm covered in you.
Ooh, okay.
I wish to know the fatal flaw that makes you long to be magnificent. Opal eyes are all I wish to see. He wants what's only yours.
Wait, is this about somebody else?
God damn, my pain fits in the palm of your freezing hand. Taking mine, but it's been promised to another.
It's been promised, oh my God.
My house of stone, your ivy grows, and now I'm covered. Clover blooms in the field, spring breaks loose. Time is near, what would he do if he found us out?
Oh.
Crescent moon, he's gonna burn this house to the ground.
Oh. Okay, come on, hit me with that bridge.
It's a fire, it's a goddamn blaze in the dark. And you started it, you started it.
You started it.
It's a war, it's the goddamn fight of my life. And you started it.
Okay, will you also... Come on, it's a tango, baby. It's a tango. Oh, I love that, dude. I love that, man. Oh. I do love that beat, though. That beat does definitely go so hard, honestly. Oh, I love when they end on the chord. Very cool, very cool. Okay, so it says right here, Ivy is the 10th track from Evermore. Tells the story of a married woman falling in love with a person who's not her husband. Ma'am, leading to a what? An affair. Naughty song. Naughty, naughty song. Bad. Bad, naughty song. No. Don't make me feel good at that. No. Stop. That one definitely... Fuck me.
Fuck, dude.
Okay, so the next one is called Cowboy Like Me. Cowboy? Dude. I love cowboys. I was a cowboy on Twitter for a while.
I'm gonna take my horse on down around the mountain.
I hope it's like super country. Like, I hope it's like really country. But okay, let's do it.
And the tennis court was covered up with some tent-like thing. And you asked me to dance, but I said dancing is a dangerous game.
Oh, okay, it's slow.
Cowboy like me, perched in the dark, telling all the rich folks anything they want to hear, like it could be love.
Ooh. Oh, that's pretty. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh. Okay.
Now you hang from my lips.
Four verses. Four verses. Yeehaw, baby.
Yeehaw.
All right, the next one is called Long Story Short. Oh, ooh, kind of up-tempo, maybe?
Faithfully, oh. I tried to pick my battles till the battle picked me.
Ooh.
Misery, like the war of words I shouted in my sleep. If your shoe fits, walk in it till you hide.
Ooh, okay.
Right down the rabbit hole. Long story short, it was a bad time.
Yeah. Oh, I like this one. Okay, I like how up-tempo this one is. I can tell she's really talking about like the her whole real history through it. Okay, let's see what verse two is.
I always felt I must look better in the rear view. Missing me.
Oh, I like these real drums now.
I'm all about you, yeah. I'm all about you.
More
keeping score now. I just keep you warm. My waves meet your shore ever and evermore.
There we go. There we go. There it is.
Long story short, I survive.
Yes, you did, bitch!
I'm all about you, right? Long story short, it was a bad time.
Yes, it was, but guess
long
what?
Story short, I survived.
You survived. Yes, ma'am. Oh, what a beautiful song. God, that is dope. Oh, I love the pocket in that, too. It ends in a really, really nice spot, too.
Because it's like, yeah, all this shit happened to me. It sucks. I fucking hated it.
But like, dude, I'm better for it. I'm here now. We survived and we're better than ever. The next song is called Marjorie. Marjorie. Marge. Marge.
This one goes out for Marge.
I forgot about my water.
Never be so clever. You forget to be kind.
Okay. I'll try.
And if I didn't know better,
ooh.
What died didn't stay dead. You're alive, so alive.
Oh.
Never be so polite, you forget your power.
Oh. I have a feeling where you're going with this.
Never wield such power.
Okay.
You forget to be polite.
Oh, big facts.
If I didn't know better, I'd think you were still around. What died didn't stay dead. What died didn't stay dead. You're alive, you're alive in my head. The autumn chill that wakes me up. Love the amber sky so much. Long limbs and frozen swims. You'd always go past where our feet could touch. Should have kept every grocery store seat, cause every scrap of you would be taken from me. Watched as you signed your name Marjorie. All your closets of backlog dreams, and how you left them all to me. What died didn't stay dead. I think you were singing to me now.
Oh,
I didn't know better.
That's the man. Oh, I couldn't help but read down here. Marge passed away in 2003. She was an opera singer who helped inspire Taylor to pursue music. In the album notes, she's credited as a background vocalist. Oh my God, the fact that Aaron worked away to get the opera, her holding those long notes in like some kind of like very synthy pad, kind of back in the mix along with the singing when she mentioned it.
Oh my God, dude.
That is so much deeper than just writing a meaningful song that's like a bop. You know, it's the fact that she actually put the time and she thought about an element that really came from the subject of the song and incorporated it into the audible piece of music. That is bravo. Moving on to track 14, we have Closure. Is it gonna give us any closure? Is it? I don't know. Whoa, 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 wait, 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 wait. Whoa, wait, what? Oh, I love that as a backbeat. Oh my God.
It's been a long time, and seeing the shape of your name still spells out pain.
Oh.
Looks like you know that now.
Oh God, the groove is good.
Yes, I got your letter. Yes, I'm doing better. It cut deep to know you right to the bone. Yes, I got you. I know that it's over. I don't need you. Closure. Your closure.
Oh God, I don't need it. I thought I needed it. I don't need
don't
it anymore.
Like some situation that needs to be handled.
Oh, get your hands off of me.
Smoothing me over. Yes, I got your letter. Yes, I'm doing better. I know that it's over. I don't need your closure.
You don't owe him shit. Leave his ass on red.
I know I'm just a wrinkle in your new life. Staying friends with iron it out so nice. It's over, I don't need your closure, closure.
Ooh.
Closure.
Oh, the drums, dude. Honestly, that's my favorite part of the track, dude. That gives it such an energy. I gotta look at this bridge, man. I know I'm just a wrinkle in your new life. Staying friends would iron it out so nice. Yeah, you wish you could just iron me out like a little crease on your collar for your shirt from American Eagle. Guilty, guilty, reaching out across the sea. The sea that you put between you and me. It's so fake. And it's so unnecessary. She can see through his like reach out to like, oh, like I need this. And she's just like, nah, nah, no. You don't, you might need it, but you don't deserve it. You don't deserve it, Brian. All right, this is track 15. It is entitled Evermore. The name of the album. And it is featuring the man, the myth, the legend
with the low voice, Mr. Justin Vernon
Bon Iver has come back for a double dose. He's double dipping in the tea swizzy hummus. And I'm not mad about it. Baby, you could double dip all day. Ooh. Okay, nice little two-quarter.
Gray November, I've been down since July.
I love when she mimics the instruments. I love that. I love that.
I replay my footsteps on each stepping stone.
Oh.
Trying to find the one where I went wrong. Writing letters, I was catching my breath. Staring out an open window, catching my death.
Oh.
And I couldn't be sure. I had a feeling so peculiar that this pain would be for evermore.
Oh, God, dude. I hope this pain isn't evermore, but peculiar? Peculiar. I love that she pronounced every syllable of that. Where's my book?
Can't remember what I used to fight for.
I'll remind you. Come on. Good songwriting.
I rewind the tape, but all it does is pause on the very moment.
Come on, send me. Send it.
And I was catching my breath. Barefoot in the wildest winter, catching my death.
Oh, put a jacket on, girl.
And I couldn't
grab your cardi
evermore.
I barely heard Justin in there. Oh. Oh, but is he gonna tackle the verse? The next one? No, he's in the bridge.
Cannot think of all the cause.
Oh, he's in his falsetto. Oh god.
Things that will be lost.
Oh,
can we just get a pause? I'm on waves of being tossed.
Oh god. They're going back and forth again.
Oh,
oh. Oh, go off! Oh, God! Oh, Justin. Oh, he went so hard! Oh! Oh, God, he went so hard! Oh, wow. Oh, sir. Sir, the swelling. Oh, faith restored. Faith restored. Oh. And the violins at the end. Oh my god, dude. Oh. And that's the end of the regular album. Dude, that is in itself such a beautiful way to end an album.
God, oh, guess what?
You thought we were gonna listen to the deluxe versions.
We're not gonna listen to the deluxe versions.
And if you're here early with me right now, guess what, baby? You can go over to my live stream that I'm doing on IG right now. Or well, not really right now, but right after this video. We're gonna be listening to Right Where You Left Me, and It's Time to Go, the two bonus tracks. And that's pretty much it for the album, guys. Wow, this has been a journey. Truly a journey. I have such a deeper appreciation for Taylor, her production quality, her writing process. You know that we go live on Twitch every Friday at 5. Last week, we actually watched the Long Pond Sessions on Disney Plus. So go follow and subscribe over there if you want that kind of content. And if you enjoyed the video here today, be sure to check out my Patreon. We have a Discord where we talk and chat all the time. Dude, honestly, I cannot believe my glasses really fogged up. I was crying so hard at Champagne Problems. Wow. That song is illegal. Yes, yes, ma'am. All right, well, I don't want to say totally goodbye to Miss Swift. We still have a lot of albums to get through, but I think that just about wraps it up for the time being for her albums. It's been a blast, and I cannot wait for the 30-song
Red
potentially coming out in December. Super, super excited about that. All right, well, that just about wraps it up for me. I'm gonna
get on the road here and start making the next video, because you guys have been blowing it up recently. So I'm trying to push out as much content as I physically possibly can. And as always, stay happy, healthy, and strong, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.